afternoon, my fellow Parkview Patriots, and parents of Patriots, and friends of Patriots, and everybody all around the world who might be tuning in to join us. So today we are going to be facing off against Fort Smith Northside. We're just going to need a few minutes here to make sure that we've got the match all set up and going. Let me get the audio turned back on here, just so we can hear some music. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us this afternoon as Little Rock Parkview Rocket League team versus the Charlie team from Fort Smith Northside. We're so glad that you decided to join us this afternoon. Glad you found your way over to our Twitch channel here at twitch.tv/LRParkview. Do keep in mind that you can follow the school on Facebook with Parkview High LRSD or on Twitter at @P_ParkviewLRSD. Go ahead and swap over to our full capture here as we wait on everybody to pop in to the match. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Are we game one of Parkview versus Fort Smith Northside? We got our kickoff, we got 5 minutes to go left here in this first match, and looks like Fort Smith is already pushing fast over to the Parkview side. We got a nice little clear there from Evan. Got a nice save. Kevin's up in the air, but had a big fake on it. Pushing the ball forward, got a nice block, but couldn't get the ball pushed quite out of Parkview's territory. Fort Smith's up in the air, trying to make something happen. Slowly getting the ball moving forward, but it's back on Parkview's side of the field once again. Here we are linging around in midfield. Once again, want to thank everybody so much for joining us this afternoon over here on our Twitch channel at twitch.tv/LRParkview. So glad you found your way over. Do keep in mind that we also have a YouTube channel where we will be... What a save! Where we will be sending all of our matches, just in case you happen to miss it over here live. Portsmouth Northside has really come out pretty strong here this afternoon, really keeping the game itself, the ball being played on Parkview side of the field, but we do have Evan here who's pushing it forward, but here we are back at midfield once again. Save. Evan is just coming through big for the Parkview team on making sure that that ball does not go into the back of our net. But if we can't make something happen on their side of the field, it's only a matter of time before a mistake happens and they score. We got Kevin who's pushing the ball up forward on the Fort Smith side of the field. Now we got some play going on over here. A little combo off the back wall, but once again, pushed back over to Parkview side of the field. Sully up on the wall, trying to get the ball pushed out and cleared. Couldn't quite make a good clear on it. Little fumble there from Fort Smith Northside. Kept them from capitalizing on the moment, but we do have one flying in from the middle of nowhere. Evan pushing the ball down the field. Got a nice little flick. Bounced off the back wall, but nobody there to capitalize on the play itself. Nice little back and forth. We are playing Charlie team from Fort Smith Northside. And on paper, this match should be pretty spectacular. Both of us are ranked about equally within the state. Just about the same number of wins versus losses. All in all, we should have a fantastic match lined up for you here this afternoon. So far, we are 3 minutes of play into the game. It is still scoreless. Lots of back and forth. Very fast action thing going on. Evan coming up big for Parkview, making three saves. I believe it was three. I may have lost count at this point because there's been so many, and that one's going to roll right in against Parkview. Good job, Fort Smith Northside, to get a goal. Minute 40 left. In match number one. Fort Smith Northside is up one goal. Got the kickoff here, still in match number one. Fort Smith's been really aggressive, pushing the ball down the field over into Parkview side of Parkview territory, but every now and then we do get little glimmers of hope and the ball gets pushed out. That near miss right there. Oh, that could have been such a good block. But Fort Smith was able to capitalize and score another goal. Kevin coming up big with the save right there. Here we are, minute 10 left in match number one, and we have Fort Smith Northside up 2-0 over Little Rock Parkview. First games are always interesting to watch because neither team really kind of knows what to expect and how to play and how aggressive they need to be and how much they need to stay back. It's usually not until the second match that both teams really begin to find their rhythm. That would have been nice. Fort Smith was there to keep the ball out of the back of their net. Watch those rebounds. Giving Fort Smith Northside another goal, making it 3-0. 24 seconds left in match number one. Do keep in mind that this is a 5-game series. So it is the first to 3 wins. Right now, Fort Smith Northside is on their way to securing the first win of the day. Nice save from Fort Smith Northside. beautiful backflip save there from Kevin to keep the ball out of Parkview's net. All right, good job, Fort Smith, taking the first game. Ladies and gentlemen, we are on our way to the second game here against Fort Smith Northside. So far for the first match, Fort Smith Northside has taken the win. They got 3-0 against Parkview. Very aggressive gameplay from them. We saw that last week as well. We managed to adapt and overcome and get the win last week. Let's see if we can capitalize this week and do the same. Parkview's come out very aggressive here. Oh! Kevin with the goal right off the bat. Pushing Parkview up 1-0. If we can hold on to this lead, we'll go on to win the second match. It'll kind of cancel out the win from Fort Smith Northside on the first. So remember, it is a 5-game series and it is a 1-2-3. Right there in the corner, Fort Smith Northside answering right back with a nice little shot right there in the corner. Sully with a near save, but couldn't quite get to the ball in time. So if you've been paying attention or if you've been joining us over the past few weeks, some of the things you've noticed that I've discussed have been the hitboxes for the cars within the game itself. There are a few different styles of hitboxes, even though there's many different styles of cars themselves. The most popular hitbox that's used is the Octane, which you can actually see almost every player in today's match using. There's only one, if I can see it all correctly, there's only one player on the entire field. Oh, is that going to roll right in? It is. Very nice job from Evan to get us a goal into the back of their net with a long shot there, making it 2-1 in favor of Parkview. So here, Spaz and Anz on the Fort Smith team. Those two cars that you saw there are both Octane cars, so obviously they use the Octane hitbox. Evan uses an Octane. Sully uses a Proteus, which actually uses an Octane hitbox. So the only person on the field is right here, our boy Kevin. He's using the Centio car, which has a Dominus hitbox. So it's a little bit longer and flatter. Makes the ball a little bit easier to dribble. Oh, what a shot. Nice little combo play action that they had going on there from Fort Smith Northside, making the game tied at 2-2. 3 minutes, 12 seconds left in match number two. Match number two has come out to be an all-out brawl. Nice block and push out from Evan there. Oh, nice little 50-51 by Parkview. Oh, Kevin comes back to keep that ball on the Fort Smith side of the field. Even though a that's not counted as a save, I'm going to count it as a save because that was spectacular. Definitely kept the ball out of the back of our net. Ooh, and with a nice air dribble, pushing that ball up and redirecting it in the air to put it in the back of the net. Say and. We're just going to call him Bok Choi. Nice save from Sully right there. Got a push out over on the Fort Smith side of the field. We have a minute and 53 seconds left to go in match number two. Fort Smith Northside is up 3 goals to Parkview's 2. Northside's been very aggressive in their gameplay. It's really kept Parkview back on their own goal, playing a lot of defense. Spent a lot of time on our side of the field. It's not necessarily how we're going to get goals. Nice little play there, but couldn't really capitalize on it. Sully coming in with a push forward. Fort Smith back to defend. Oh, what a shot from Evan. Just pushing it right past one of the Fort Smith players. Getting in the back of their net, tying the game up at 3-3. Paradox tried to make a save, but couldn't quite catch it. Minute 5 left in match number 2. We have a tie ball game, ladies and gentlemen. Save as well. Again, not registered by the game, but it's just because the ball wasn't really close enough to the goal, necessarily right on target, to actually count as a shot on goal. So it didn't count as a save, but it's a save in my book, as it should be in yours as well. Keeping that game tied at 3-3, we have 20 seconds left in match number 2. Here in the last 10 seconds from Parkview so that we can push a win. Instead, it looks like we're going to push overtime for match number 2. All right, overtime. Whoever scores first is going to be the winner of the match. Overtime is usually a funny situation because it's either going to be over like super quick or it takes forever to actually play out. With the matchup, at least on paper, that we've seen from these two teams, it's a very balanced balanced pair. So while the first game resulted in a win for Fort Smith Northside, the second match has actually come up as a tie, and now we're playing overtime. So as I mentioned on paper, these two teams seem very close to each other. Ooh, what a pitch out. Nice little boop up to keep it from going in the back. Can we get that next save? There we go. Fort Smith Northside hanging around in the corner. Probably trying to get boost as well as just seeing about how the play is going to go. So close right there. I know sometimes we jokingly say that Rocket League is, you know, soccer with cars, and essentially it really is. Watch that rebound. But there really is an ebb and a flow to the game. There's really a back and a forth. You see this in basketball as well, which can be pretty fast paced. Soccer really has that back and forth. You sit back, you wait for your opportunities to strike, keep your defense going. When you catch those openings, you take advantage as best you can. What you want to do is make a result and a goal. Paradox up in the air just to keep that ball in play, because Sully was on the prowl. Here we go. Got a nice little push forward there from Kevin before Smith's on the defense. We are 2 minutes into overtime. Remember, it is whoever scores first is going to win game number two. Evan and Kevin coming in there, both getting flicks on the ball to push it forward. Can we get a redirect? We cannot. Fort Smith is going to push that ball out. We're back on defense again. We got Sully back there pushing the ball forward. Paradox coming in, knock it down. Sully and Kevin both going for the ball to keep it out to the side. Now it's up in the air. What do we got? Like an old-fashioned melee right there in the goal. Kept it down, Sully pushing it forward off of a nice little flick from Kevin to get it in the middle of the field, but Fort Smith was on the defense. Paradox coming around again, Sully with the block. Kevin pushing forward, got a tap, sending it to midfield. Play, tried to get the flick, but Evan said, nope. Got the nice little block to keep it out of the back of the net. Oh, Bok Choi scoring the goal, getting the win for Fort Smith. What a game. 3 minutes, 30 seconds, 36 seconds into overtime. That's an angle right there. Oh, looks like it was really an own goal from Parkview. But that's okay. Those things happen. Kevin was trying to get a misdirect or a redirect on it, and instead got a misdirect on it and put it in the back of the net. That's all right. Getting ready for match number three against Fort Smith Northside. We'll be right back. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, patriots, families of patriots, parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, pets, everywhere in between. We're so glad that you're joining us this afternoon. Found your way over to our Twitch channel here, where we got Parkview versus Fort Smith Northside. We are on the third match of this afternoon. Unfortunately, I have to report that Fort Smith Northside has won the first two matches, and it is the first of three games. Or three wins for the day. That's going to determine who is the winner for this matchup between these two teams. Game number one seemed to be handled and won pretty easily by Fort Smith Northside. It was 3-0, but in game number two, we wound up going into overtime with a 3-3 scoreline, where ultimately Fort Smith Northside won out with a misdirect off of one of the Parkview players into the net. If Fort Smith Northside goes on to win this third match, then they will have won the matchup for the day. And I know the guys are ready to say, nope, we're not ready to give up yet. What a save there from Evan. Just based on the sheer volume of saves that Evan's had today, he'd be like goalie of the year. Here we are, we got Spaz trying to make something happen. Do some little fake outs, some jukes. Couldn't quite make anything of it, though. And the ball got pushed out. Kevin's up in the air. Got the ball pushed forward. Spaz is there to get the block and get the save for Fort Smith. Ooh. that block, keep it right out of the back of the net, but Sully was coming around there and got it pushed back over into their side, but could not capitalize. Spaz pushing it forward for Smith. Paradox pushing it way, way forward for Smith. Gonna get a rebound. We got a save there from Evan. Sully with a save. Seeing the same kind of aggressive play style that Fort Smith had in the first match. What another save there from Parkview. Kevin getting it saved out. Paradox getting it redirected, keep it out the front of the goal. But here comes Evan. Couldn't quite keep the ball down enough to get it in the back of the net. But Sully boops it forward, keeping it back on Fort Smith's side of the field. Here we have a turn of the tides. We're back on Parkview's side of the field. And we have Spaz. There comes Kevin. Ball's back up in the air. Spaz trying to make something happen. Couldn't quite make it. Paradox was up, but couldn't quite make anything happen. And here we have Bok Choy keeping the ball moved over to Parkview's side. Trying to get a little hesitation. Oh, Paradox trying to squeeze something in there at the top of the net. Couldn't quite get it. Kevin trying to dribble forward. Couldn't quite make it happen. Spaz turned around again. Evan with another little push out. And another push out. Kevin right behind him pushing the ball out. Got Evan coming in but couldn't quite connect with the ball. We got less than a minute left to go. It's hard to believe this match is already almost over and it's still scoreless. Thanks to and I spoke too soon, didn't I? There you go, Bok Choy with the goal. 50 seconds left in match number one. It was bound to happen sooner or later. Much defense as Parkview's been having to play. They were bound to find a hole somewhere. Game's not over yet, though. We still have 47 seconds left in this third match. Parkview can manage to score and get it tied up. And we could go to overtime. Evan's up in the air, hitting it off the back of the wall. Kevin's up. Oh my god, that was so close. That would have been such a good goal if that had happened. You got Paradox on the prowl right here for Fort Smith Northside. There comes Bok Choy pushing it forward off the wall. Sully with another save. Someone trying to push it around to make something happen. There goes Sully pushing the ball forward. 50-50 right there. Got pushed up in the air. We got 5 seconds left in the match. Are we going to be able to get something into the back of their net? Remember, the game is not over until the ball actually touches the ground. So we will sit here. There it goes. Congratulations to Fort Smith Northside on their win for the day. They were the first one of the 3 wins out of the 5 matches that we could have played. We thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. Y'all be safe out there. Much love to you.
I'm